Hi, this is Wayne with Sears PartsDirect. Do you ever get a nasty static shock when you're blowing snow? When it's really cold and dry outside, static electricity can build up through the chute area and then discharge through you when you touch a snowblower. Sears PartsDirect sells a static charge grounding harness that's easy to install and includes everything you need to fix that static shock problem. We're going to ground the chute by connecting it to the engine shroud with that kit. Before you start, park the snowblower in a level area and remove the ignition key. Allow the engine to cool. Use a 1/2-inch socket to remove the lock nut from the tilt mechanism on the chute. Install the larger stud terminal of the grounding harness onto the bolt. Install a washer on each side of the harness terminal connector. Then reinstall the lock nut. Tighten the lock nut firmly so that the terminal doesn't rotate with the tilt mechanism. Connect the other end of the grounding harness to the muffler shield bolt on the lower left side of the engine. Carefully bend the barrel of the terminal away from the muffler shield so that the cable isn't resting against the shield. Secure the grounding harness loosely to the chute support bracket using the 7-inch cable tie. Mark the grounding harness 18 inches from the tilt mechanism terminal. This will be the location of the farthest cable tie from the terminal. Connect the grounding cable to the front tilt cable using the 4-inch cable tie, leaving enough slack in the grounding cable to allow free movement when adjusting the chute tilt. Install 3 more evenly spaced cable ties along the grounding cable and the front tilt cable to secure them together. Trim the loose ends from the cable ties. Hey, thanks for watching. Be sure to check out our other videos here on the Sears PartsDirect YouTube channel, and don't forget to subscribe.